Hey everyone, it's Rachel back again with another reaction video. Today I will be reacting to a new single from Kingdom of Giants. It's off of their upcoming album Passenger that'll be out on October 16th through Sharptone Records. The song I will be reacting to today is called Wayfinder. I have loved the singles off this album so far. I think my favorite is Sync. It's stuck in my head a lot. I love that song, super catchy. But Kingdom of Giants is fantastic. I've talked about it before. I love them. I've been anticipating this release. I pre-ordered the album. I'm excited for it. The expectations are definitely high with Kingdom of Giants, and I think it should be a solid song given the other three singles that they've put out so far. So let's get straight into it. I don't normally pause videos when I'm reacting to them, but I don't want to just keep talking over the song. But I did want to point out, Passenger is the name of the album. I love when the album title is dropped in a song. This wasn't the title track, like Passenger or anything like that. It wasn't a title track on there. It wasn't one of those. So I didn't know going into it, but so the title has been dropped in the song. I just wanted to point that out because I got really stoked about it. So anyway, let's continue listening to the song now.
We got to die. Can't seem to find the real
So now I get read from Kingdom of Giants had mentioned on Twitter when I talked about doing this video that I should wait until the music video drops. And I'm definitely glad that I did. What an awesome music video. Great job on this. But anyway, Kingdom of Giants, Wayfinder, let's discuss. I don't think I enjoy this one more than Sync yet, but it definitely comes close. On my first listen, I loved this. It keeps me pumped for the album. I'm definitely glad I pre-ordered it. This was a little bit different, had some stuff in there I'm definitely ready to discuss because I found it interesting, but let's jump into that. To start off with, the effects that were used in there, you can hear it from the very beginning in the intro. There's this, I don't know how to describe it other than, I feel like I use the word spacey a lot, but there's this intro that's got this cool, the bass line of the whole song as well. There's just a very interesting tone to the song. That, in addition to how clean the drumming sounded, there were so many accents and whatnot on this that sounded so clean. The drumming was another factor on here that sounded really amazing. I think that cool bass line and all the fantastic music going on in the beginning almost overpower the first portion of vocals that come in. So that's fine, but I was admiring that in the beginning more so than I think I even noticed the vocals when they first hit. I liked that before the chorus kicked in, it had this open, slower, it wasn't too chaotic or anything, but the pre-chorus musically was a bit open and spacey, kind of. When the chorus hit, I thought that was super catchy, especially the next time it came around, hearing it again. But for me, I think it's really hard to beat Sync. The chorus on that song is stuck in my head so often, and I just love the way that that's done. It's a hard competition there. The chorus in this song was definitely catchy, and another one that I can definitely see getting stuck in my head again, as it already is. I obviously was excited enough to pause the video when I heard the album title dropped in this song, so there isn't exactly a title track, but this one had the album name in it, so that's good enough for me. I liked that, especially because I was not expecting it. I didn't know, so it was a little fun to find in there. Excited enough to pause it. I never do that, as I mentioned, so after the clean chorus, the guitar and bass continues grooving along. The unclean vocals come in. That part was one of my favorites. It sounded awesome. The lyrics, along with just the emphasis that I feel like the drums were putting on some of the lyrics, too, it just sounded so good. I was definitely admiring that. I think it's right after the first repetition of the chorus, so the second time that we hear it, where the song kind of spaces out and there is that electronic sound that I was talking about, and then it goes into this part where it ties in that electronic sound with a little bit of a musical breakdown, and again, just sounded so good. So I don't have any complaints about this track either, and I feel like that's been the case a lot lately. There is one part, I believe it's directly after the first repetition of the chorus, so the second time that we hear the chorus, it's about halfway through the song, I think, where the song kind of spaces out and you hear a lot of that electronic part that I was talking about, and then that goes on for a bit, and then it ties back into the vocals and this bit of a breakdown with the music, and it sounded so good with all of that tying together and how that spaced out part of the song. You hear that electronic component and it just continues consistently through the vocals kicking back in and the guitar, bass, drums breaking down a bit. I just thought that that was awesome. I loved the way it sounded. The end of the song, the repetition, as the outro comes in, just solidified the catchiness to me. I was jamming along to it. I love this track. I think that it's a great addition to the other singles that have been put out. To me, this song definitely sounded like progression. And don't get me wrong, I love the prior albums that Kingdom of Giants has put out. All the Hell You've Got to Spare is still one that I listen to very often. But listening to this song and considering the other singles that they put out, I am anticipating this album a lot. It's up there for me with like Moths to Flames. The bar is definitely being set even higher for Kingdom of Giants with these singles. The catchy choruses, the amazing production on these songs, the way that it just seems very well thought out. A lot of details that I'm hearing, I appreciate a lot. So I'm blown away by this album so far from what I've heard off the singles. Let me know what you thought in the comments, and if you have a song that you would like to be added to the list that I work off of when I am doing request-based videos, I'll put the link in the description. Both links, actually, there are two different ones. Both of them will be in the description of the video, as well as the invite link for the Discord server. There are more people joining every week, it seems like. A lot of fun conversation going on, so if you wanted to check that out, all links in the description. And lastly, if you're enjoying the style of music and content that I post on my YouTube channel, I post more music-related content on my Instagram. My handle is @wolfandthesea. I will put it up here on the screen for you if you wanted to give me a follow. And as always, thank you very much for watching. I appreciate it.